You must have got taller. I'm talking. You look tall.
I'm skinny.
Wait, we're about the same height.
Hey, Vander, he's a middleweight now. Look at him.
Well, but you don't remember we're the same height.
Was he a middleweight when you fought him?
We was in the ring when you hit me with the head one time. I was like,
oh man, here we go.
Hey, he hit me with his head. I don't even put my head on. You have your head.
It looks like we're gonna finally get a Tyson Fury and Deontay Wilder. What do you think of that fight? If assuming Tyson Fury takes
Fury care of business. Is a joke. So, Tyson Fury's a joke.
I think it can be competitive, but it can also be awkward because both of them got long arms, and if one keep bagging back, and I actually think that in one quick shot that Deontay go, the fight could be over.
The Fury's had his problems, been out of the ring a couple of years, drug problems, plus he's been down by a cruiserweight. So, going back to your point, you think that would give Wilder a big advantage?
No. Wilder hit hard anyway.
Yeah.
I'm telling you, it don't make no difference who you put in there with him. What are you going to do? He's going to throw that 1-2, and if he catch you, I'm telling you, he's in great shape, and that's what he do. I'm telling you, when a guy have confidence, what do he do?
He
practice like he want to fight. This is what he's going to do. I think this can be awkward for it because this is the first time he fights somebody with longer arms, but what difference that make is the guy's not quick with them long arms. You know, he's not quick, but it's just awkward.
Now, Amanda, you were talking about Deontay's confidence. Did you see this morning he crashed Tyson Fury's weigh-in to basically confront him, trying to promote the fight? Did you happen to see that at all?
No, I didn't. You got to show it to me.
Right.
Yeah. What? He came in.
He went all the way to Belfast.
Oh, sure.
And he was getting a lot of love and support from all those UK fans.
Yeah, you know, I'm telling
you. Who you got on here, Deontay?
Yeah, that Deontay Wilder flew into Belfast for Tyson Fury's fight.
You live in Belfast?
No. I got a correspondent out there. That's their footage. Deontay crashed the weigh-in, got into it with Tyson Fury's dad, and then after the weigh-in, they went to a hotel lobby and they had to be separated. It was quite the show.
Yeah, it could be partially important.
I'm sure it is, but people like the hype, you know.
Absolutely.
The people like the hype, you know. To me as a fighter, I wasn't that way because I kind of felt that it could backfire. Right. You know, it could backfire. Anybody can get hurt at any given time because somebody else take it seriously. And, you know, as fighters, we go in there and we go out there and do our very best when it's all said and done. You know, we want to knock the person out, not that we wanted to kill him and all this stuff. It's a boxing match. You want to do your very best, but whatever, sell the tickets and stuff, you can try to do it in a mean and a fashion that it draw people. But I think when you joke too much, you lose your edge. And then all of a sudden, that guy in your mind, he got him in there. So I ain't like joking about nothing. So I wasn't going to say much. And I realized when I go out there, I will be in the very best shape that I could be in, because you know what? The quicker you take him out, the more fight you have in you. At any given time, or elbow or anything, any kind of accident, it's over. When the referee stops the fight, it's over. So, you know, you can't take no chances in none of these situations. And, you know, so you get to know how it's going to turn out. You get somebody else hyped in yourself and they do something crazy.
Everybody wanted to see Deontay against Anthony Joshua, and that's not going to happen, it looks like, anytime soon. Well, I know probably you as a fan yourself wanted to see that fight. What did
next
you think
year.
Of it not happening?
I think it'll happen next year.
I think life about patience. I just think about every time something was held on. You know what? It benefited me because you know what?
So you'll get somebody to make sure he's squared away.
I don't make that many mistakes, so I'm not going to do nothing crazy. So I'm always going to be good. So you ask what's going to happen if this thing play out 6 or 7 more years? Who can't keep themselves? Who gonna get out of line? Is it Deontay, Joshua? Who gonna get out of line? Who gonna eat too much? Who gonna get too stiff? Who would only think? Who really lived their life as a boxer? The one who lived a better life as a boxer is one gonna. Cause when it go down the line, is how well do you take care of yourself? You know what? You know. I don't think Anthony Joshua gonna just get blowed up. You're not Anthony Joshua. I don't think Deontay gonna get that. I don't think he gonna get that.
Well, just to kind of go along that, you were talking about who's gonna take care of themselves the best, and you just said you don't think Deontay's gonna get fat. Deontay actually talked about possibly moving down to cruiserweight. I mean, he's coming in fight night weighing 215 pounds. So he says if he fights Joshua, if the Joshua fight may not be there, he may go down to cruiserweight, win some titles down there. Could you even see that happening?
Wow, but I wouldn't think that would be right. I would think that why would you, as a heavyweight, you know, not realize you the king of the hill? Why are you gonna slide down to mess with somebody below you? Oh no, he wouldn't do that.
He's not gonna get the money he's getting.
Yeah.
No, that's what I'm saying. You ain't gonna now
cut weight.
You know, you're not. You wouldn't carry yourself down.
Yeah, it doesn't make sense.
I wouldn't think that's a smart move.
I think the reason he said it was because of the names, but I mean, and use it. You know, he just unified.
He stand up under Deontay's punch. And I'm not sure he's got enough punch to take Deontay down.
Speaking of that, you were known as the best cruiserweight ever.
Yeah.
What do you think of Usyk unifying all four titles, the first undisputed since you at cruiserweight?
That's what I'm saying. I'm telling him he's a good guy. I'm telling him, like, now anything he need to come up and do something.
Right. He's talked about moving up to heavyweight.
I'm telling him if he move up, I'm telling him, you know, because you know what he bring? He bring the speed. I'm telling him, you know, when he found out them boys hit hard and all this, I'm saying, because, you know, when I remember moving up there and I was like, I did that, dog. Oh, shoot. I get hit in the arm. That stuff started hurt. And all that, then all of a sudden, it took me a little while to get accustomed to having the big guys when he did them 10-ounce gloves. Them 10-ounce gloves hurt.
Thank you so much, guys.
Thank you.